All right.
My name is Indira Ramsar, and I have four audience members today. My brother Timothy, my dad Duke, my mother Carla, and my other brother Duke. Namaste, and greetings from Guyana. My name is Indira, and this is my cultural artifact project. Growing up, I remember my family sat down for dinner, my father reminding us that the dinner table was where lessons, culture, and proper conversations were taught. The cultural artifact my group chose was food. Together, we combine all of our separate backgrounds into one unified speech. I will be going into depth about the Guyanese culture. But in order for me to explain my artifact to you, I'll first be laying out some background information, such as Guyana as the country and the history that we have there. I will then be explaining my artifact, which was the Guyanese pepper pot, and then I will be concluding with how the dish is prepared. One people, one nation, one destiny. Six powerful words that define Guyana's motto. This one phrase holds so much meaning into the country and my family as well. Guyana is a country along the northern coast of South America. This is where my father was born and raised. In 1968, though, he realized that he wanted a better life and went out and searched for it. My father came over here from Guyana with nothing but the clothes on his back and not down to his name. And he worked very hard, spending way over 40 hours a week at a minimum wage job, going to school, and devoting his life to Jesus Christ. While my father was paving his way for a new beginning, he was also setting money aside to help his brothers and sisters that were in Guyana to come to North America with him. When my father left Guyana, he guessed the population was about 500,000 people. Now, the population is 779,000 people. Although my father left Guyana many years ago, he has done his utmost best to instill the culture into us through stories, pictures, and of course, the food. Now, the Guyanese pepper pot is the national dish of Guyana. This dish is very important to the Guyanese culture and is often prepared on special holidays such as Christmas. A majority of the Guyanese food that we create is prepared with our hands and eaten with our fingers as well. For the most part, Guyanese men and women help create the food. It brings the family much closer together when everyone comes into the kitchen and helps put all the ingredients together to make the dish. I remember as a child, I would help my father prepare roti with my brothers and sisters. Now roti is like a bread that you can always pair up with any kind of curry. My brothers and sisters and I love being able to play with the dough and then eat our creations. And as we got older, we were able to help with more advanced dishes such as the Guyanese pepper pot. The preparation of the Guyanese pepper pot is actually quite simple. I've made it quite a few different ways, but this is the recipe that I'm going to show you that my father taught me. And all the recipes all come up to the same exact dish. Only one pot is used in the making the Guyanese pepper pot, which is the pressure cooker. First, you fill the cooker with 4 tablespoons of oil, and then you let it simmer. You then chop up half of a medium onion and set it into oil, along with half of a tablespoon of minced garlic. The dish isn't even halfway done yet, and your house is filled with a tasty and exotic aroma. You then let the ingredients mix and fry for a few minutes before adding 4 cups of water. You then add 2 tablespoons of caspari, C-A-S-R-E-E-T, and a tablespoon of sodium glutamate, and 2 tablespoons of salt. You then turn up the heat on the pot and let it boil for 5 minutes. Then we add a package of dubi, put it in the pressure cooker at the top, and then just walk away. This is how the finished product looks with white rice and roti, as I explained earlier. In conclusion, your culture defines who you are, and I'm proud that my father instilled this culture into me every night at the dinner table. I'm also happy that I was able to give a little bit of my culture to you. From the beginning when I explained the country of Guyana and the background I have there, to the explanation of the Guyanese pepper pot, to the actual recipe, I hope I explained everything enough to you for you to learn a lot about me and get the recipe so you can make it for yourself as well. The more you learn about another culture, the more diverse you become. The more we learn about each other, the stronger we mold as one. One people, one nation, one destiny. Thank you. Okay, do we have any questions?
Yes.
Go ahead.
What does the guardian's flag look like?
The guardian's flag looks like my bracelet, red, yellow, and green colors, and like my hair. Any other questions?
Mommy.
Thanks a lot.
Okay. Mommy.